had his school. All the time he put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night his light will shine. God is good, God is good all the time. If you're walking through the valley and there's shadows all around, not fear, he will guide you, he will keep you safe and sound. He has promised to never leave you nor forsake you, and his word is true. God is good all the time. He put a song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest his light will shine. God is good, God is good all the time. We were sinners, so unworthy, still for us he chose to die. Filled us with his Holy Spirit, now we can stand and testify that his love is everlasting. His mercies, they will never end. God is good all the time. He put the song of praise in this heart of mine. God is good all the time. Through the darkest night his light will shine. God is good, God is good all the time.
That is ever so true thing to say, that God is very good. I want to share with you my testimony. I lived my youth not knowing God. I often thought in childhood and in my youth years that will God exist and who has created me? But as I was taught at school that we are just the production of evolution, that's what I believed. Also, I thought that when I die, that's the end of the story, that's the end of everything, and there is no real purpose in that sense in my life. I grew up in a good family. I'm thankful for my parents. I had a safe home and safe family and relatives, and I didn't have problems in that sense. And also all the people around of me thought that I have a good life and things go fluently. I'm fairly okay at school and I have good friends. No problems from that point of view. But also I suffered a lot through my childhood and my youth about a horrible dream. It was a nightmare that I had weekly, sometimes even more frequently. I drop in that dream to a darkness where I knew that there is no way out and it will last forever. And that was a horrible thing, and I had nobody to share about it, and I started fearing death even when I was a child. Always when I heard news about accidents or something, I thought it could be me. That could happen to me, and then I end up to this darkness, everlasting darkness, where there is no way out. In my teenage years, I attended Lutheran church camp and studied the Bible a bit, and I got some interest into God during those years. But unfortunately, there were nobody helping me forward. Some friends were mocking me that, why do you go to the youth evenings? And I stopped doing that totally. And from 15, when I was 15 years old until 22, 23, I did all the things in my life that I have later regretted, and I have really needed to pray for forgiveness, not only before God, but from many people also. I attended a music school in Ireland when I was 22, 21 and 22 years old. And in the same youth flat, there was a Nigerian student who was a pastor of a Methodist church. So me being an atheist and him being a full committed Christian, he always came with me at the same time to the dinner table and started asking interesting questions about the purpose of life and how did I come to earth and what is the purpose of my life and where will I go when I die. And I sometimes got quite angry because I really didn't have any answers to him. What I remember from that man, whom I have never met since, is that he was very loving and kind and friendly to me. And I knew that his heart is honest and he has found something what I haven't got. And about 2 weeks before I left back to Finland, this man came to me again, talked about God and said to me that, Esa-Pekka, you will become a Christian one day. And I really got angry with him and I was about to fight with him. If I were used to fighting earlier, I really would have done that. I was just upset about what he said. I thought, I'm an atheist and I'm happy with my life. Why do you come to say to me anything else? Why do you say to me that I would need God? Soon after that, I met with a Christian girl in Helsinki and I fell in love first sight. And it was a great disappointment to me when she finally said that, yes, I am a Christian, I know Jesus. And I thought, oh no, I hoped so that she would come into her senses. I told that to many of my friends also. But as the time went by, the fear of death grew inside of me. And I started realizing that I have done many wrong things in my life. I wouldn't call them, I have committed sins by that time yet, but this inner anxiety grew. And I started reading the Bible, the book which I had loved about and told to many that it is just fairy tales. I took that book and I started reading it. And I read and I read it again and again. And finally came the day when I was alone in our summer cottage. And I again took the Bible and I started reading from the Gospel of John chapter 15. And there were especially two verses and two sentences which Jesus spoke and were written down on this Bible. The first verse was saying that, without me, you cannot do anything. And the other verse was that, it's not that you chose me, but I chose you. And I totally broke down in my tears and cried unto God for forgiveness. I confessed to him all my sins. I confessed my wicked heart to him. And I said, Jesus, I need you. You need to come to help me. I need that you cleanse me and that you give me eternal life. And that very moment, I so clearly felt Jesus coming to me and giving a clear vision of such brightness I had never felt in my heart. I knew that Jesus took away my sin and gave me a new pure heart and gave me a new possibility to start again this life. And I was then 23 years old man. And from that moment onwards, I have not hesitated whether God exists and what Jesus has done for my sins, and not only for my sins, but for everybody's, anybody's sins, who comes before him and confesses sins and asks for forgiveness. And as we sang earlier here, that God is good. This is my testimony. I have found relationship with living God and he is my Father and I will be with him when I die. The fear of death has been removed from my heart and I know to whom I believe. I know who was crucified on the cross for my sins. I know who rose from the death to conquer death. And I really ask and I pray that you would humble yourself before Jesus and confess that he is the Lord of Lords And he's the King of Kings before whom every bow needs to bow. And now is the day, now is the day of good news, and now is the day for anybody to come to Jesus and receive him as a Savior and as a Lord. Thank you very much, and God bless you.
You are my strength when I am weak. You are the treasure that I seek. You are my all in all. Seeking you as a precious jewel, Lord, to give up I'd be a fool. You are my all in all. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Taking my sin, my cross, my shame, blessing against, I bless your name. You are my holy home. When I fall down, you lift me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. You are my holy home.